Good evening to all of you. Tonight we shall start. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Sachidananda Murtaye Nisprapanchaya Santaya Niralambaya Tejase Om Sankaram Sankaracharyam केशवं वादरायणं सत्रभासकृतं वंदे भगवन्तो पुनः पुनः ईश्वरगुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद व्याप्तदेहाय त्रिदक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ शान्तिः 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 हरिः ॐ ॐ गंगरुभ्यो नमः ॐ गंगणपतये नमः ॐ ऐं सरस्वतये नमः ॐ क्लीं कलिकाये नमः ॐ क्लीं भद्रकाली नमः ॐ दुं दुर्गाये नमः ॐ ह्रीं नमः शिवाय हरिः ॐ So now we are here today to study the Gupta Sadhana, the secrets of the Tantra Vidya, the secrets of the Tantra Vidya. So the secrets of the Tantra Vidya so we have to understand what is the right meaning of Tantra. We have many meanings of the Tantras. One of the right meaning of the Tantras. The right meaning of the Tantras, how to be free from the miseries, sufferings, difficulties. This is the aim of Tantra Vidya. So, there is many techniques, and Tantra also has many branches. Like we study yoga, and yoga has the many branches. Same thing, the Tantra also has many branches as well. Depends what kind of Tantra Vidya you practice in order to expansion of the consciousness and coming out of the miseries, then and you are going to guided by the Parasakti in order to attain the Shiva Tattva. So and today we are going to study out of Gupta Sadhana. We already study Kriya Yoga, Tava Sadhana, Panchatattva, Kumari Puja. Then today we are going to study fifth sadhana. That is called Kaya Siddhi. How to get the perfections of the Jivatma. And how to get perfection of the Jivatma. Kriya Yoga. So Kriya Yoga first, second is Savasadhana, third is Panchatattva, fourth is Kumari Puja, fifth is the Kaya Siddhi. And so on, there is 10 kind of Gupta Sadhana. So let we shall speak today the Kaya Siddhi. Then Panchopasana. शक्ति साधन षडशोपचार पूजा पंचाग्नि साधन चक्र पूजा सो लेट वी शैल गो टू द काया सीट दिस इज एंड वी हैव बीन स्टडी ऑलरेडी कुमारी पूजा इज कंप्लीटेड देन टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी काया सीट काया मीन्स दिस फिजिकल बॉडी काया सीधी एक रासायनिक प्रक्रिया है जिसके द्वारा शरीर की व्याधि रहित जरा प्रभाव तथा मृत्यु भय से मुक्त किया जाता है सो देयर इज द स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ टेक्निक्स एंड इज गोइंग टू हेल्प टू बी फ्री फ्रॉम ऑल काइंड ऑफ सिकनेस जरा प्रभाव एंड also one can free from the old age very interesting so that means he can remain young tatha mrityu bhay se mukt kiya jata hai so one can free from also fear of a death so one can get the perfection of the annamaya kosha the physical body Because annamaya kosha has the sickness, annamaya kosha, the physical body, stula sarir, has the old age, young age, middle age. Then our this annamaya kosha also has the death, immortal body. Sarir ke samasta ango aur कोशिकाओं के नवजीवन का संचार किया जाता है सो थ्रू द स्पेशल टेक्निक्स ऑफ द तंत्र विद्या वन मे हैव द रिवाइटलाइज्ड द प्राणिक एनर्जी इवन ए रिवाइटलाइज द माइंड एज वेल The emotions as well, and our nerve system as well. इस रासायन का प्रक्रिया में पारद और अभ्रक का प्रयोग होता है. So, in this kind of physical kriya, they have special kind of medicines or the pranayam they use. Mercury is one part, and this abhrak. Abhrak, I don't know exactly. But I can check out for you what is actually abhraka. So that the special kind of things you can use to be a young and fear from death means out of the means free from the fear of death. That means there is no death, there is no old age, and that is also Ayurvedic science as well. I know in Ayurvedic science there are certain medicines or certain kind of panchakarma you do as per the research basis one can stay as young as well and one can have the young pranic energy as well all the time similarly the tantra vidya has its own science to keep our physical body stula sarir dhanamaya kosha remain perfect perfect means no sickness no corona no cancer no corona even I mean there is no sickness and there is no and you remain can young doesn't matter how old Doesn't matter whatever your age will be, whatever age is doesn't matter. You can be 100 years, so you can be 200 years, you can be 300 years, but you can be young all the time. So that no old age. So this is also, and I have been heard one lecture. A guru from West Bengal, he used to speak. I don't know his name actually. Swami. Also his name like. Something in the Shiva and like something like Shivananda or something. He always see that how you think that you will be, because your DNA, how you think they will be, you understand me? Because you know the special kind of DNA that make you young, old, sickness, whatever you are doing in the samsara or spiritual path. So it's very important how actually your input, the thoughts, the positive thoughts. Then is rasayanika prakriyame paradaro abhraka. So they use kind of mercury and abhraka. I have to check in English. I don't know actually. Abhraka.
Maybe sulfur.
That is very nice. Abhraka also there is a abhraka in English. I have to check. So this abhraka is a classical Ayurvedic formulation that employs the use of abhraka as calcinide, mica as, with treating and managing a variety of health anomalies, including sexual and reproductive problems, respiratory disorders, liver and abdominal diseases, mental and psychosomatic disorders. So this is the abhraka bhasma. They see that. So abhraka bhasma is an Ayurvedic medicine for cold and cough and debility due to old age. This product is manufactured. So abhraka is the, you understand now a little bit, what is abhraka now already?
Please repeat.
Abhraka, I have to properly find it. This kind of abhraka they use for many other things, but I don't understand exactly what is abhraka is. Product is abhraka bhasma. Meaning of abhraka.
Ashes.
Abhraka. Ashes is okay.
You can
abhraka eat. Means asbestos. Translation abhraka. Abhraka. That is very nice. They say abhraka is called mica. So you can find out mica, M-I-C-A. That is called mica. Say a bahupayuk khanij. This is the mines that are coming from. This actually they bring from the mine, the digging. Even kayantar is a chattan cotton roop mein paya jata. So where is a lot of fire? Understand? So where have big fires? And that is the mines there. बहुत पतली पतली परस्त में चिरा जा सकता है यह रंग रहते हैं हल्के पीले हरे सो दैट इज लाइक येलो कलर्स मिका आर द ग्रुप ऑफ मिनरल्स एंड दैट दे सो यू कैन से मिका M-I-C-A मिका एंड यू कैन चेक दैट आल्सो दिस इज मिका आर द ग्रुप ऑफ मिनरल्स व्हिच आउटस्टैंडिंग फिजिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इज दैट इंडिविजुअल मिका क्रिस्टल्स कैन इजिली बी स्प्लाइट इनटू एक्सट्रीमली थिन एंड इलास्टिक प्लेट्स. This characteristics is described as perfect basal cleavage. Mica is common in igneous and metamorphic rock and is occasionally found as a small flakes in sedimentary rock. It is a particularly prominent in many grunties, pegmatites and seeds and books of mica several feet across have been found in some pegmatites. So that is the mica. So you got now the word mica. So mica is a special kind of stones. And that is going to, you can find where the big fires, that means like maybe composed by fires, like maybe volcano, they don't write volcano actually, but that is how they say it.
Yeah, volcanoes, the eye, only fire that burns stones and minerals, volcano.
Exactly.
And yep. you can buy the ashes of the burned stones from the volcano. You can buy this bentonite, zeolite.
Yeah. And also the avrak, the mica, actually it has potassium, sodium, lithium. So there also three things you can find: potassium, sodium, and lithium. So three things are a combination with this avrak. So another thing is, so very interesting that says this mica doesn't matter how much the fire there. Understand how much the fire, but it's not going to burn at all. So they say that, and this kind of stones, and actually it was not going to burn by the fire. So it's very interesting. Avrak means mica. Others means mica. So now we got it. So very interesting that. And so later we shall go further. So mercury and the avrak they use. So it is actually, it means when potassium and sodium and lithium. So these are the helping to our all. It means it vitality, right? This is vitalized you. So you can free from actual old age, or body became healthy and free from sickness. They say kaulachari ko ek sadhana ke roop mein कार्य सिद्धि का अभ्यास करना चाहिए कौलाचार्य सो देयर वी ऑलरेडी स्टडी कौलाचार्य सो वी से दक्षिणाचार्य कौलाचार्य बामाचार्य थ्री काइंड ऑफ आचार्य द प्रैक्टिस तांत्रिक साइंस कौलाचार्य को एक साधना के रूप में कार्य सिद्धि का अभ्यास करना चाहिए तो हैव अ प्रैक्टिस एडवांस एज अ तंत्र दे शुड बी ओवर मास्टरी ऑफ देयर ग्रॉस बॉडी द फिजिकल बॉडी द अन्नमय कोश Because without annamaya kosha, without physical body, he can't do any sadhanas, right? You need to have the good body as well. So therefore, as per the Hatha Yoga, concern, asanas, pranayam, mudras, bandhas we do. Why? Why need to have proper diets? Why need proper discipline? Because we need our physical body, the annamaya kosha, perfect. So that we can do any kind of sadhana, especially the science of tantra aur antarik tatvon ki ye abhyas ke sharir ke bhitar ke visakt tatv bahar nikalte hain aur antarik tatv ko shuddhi hoti so when you are use such kind of medicines even if practicing different kind of pranayama and so on so what happening so we can free from all kind of toxins and poison from our body so that our body can pure and our body and ready And for to do sadhana. For example, somebody sitting meditating like Lord Buddha. He was sitting and meditating under tree. But you need have good body as well, right? You need have proper strength. You need have proper mind. You need have proper psychology. You need have proper emotions, right? Otherwise, very difficult to meditate under tree. Am I clear that? Very difficult. So therefore, physical body. Is very very important. So kaya siddhi ke abhyas se sharir ke bhitar ke visakt, visakt means poisons. So when kaya siddhi means to get perfections of the annamaya kosha, so that it can, so that through this annamaya kosha, through this our jivatma through this sulastari, so we can do proper sadhana. So kaya siddhi is very important. Kaya means physical body, siddhi means great perfections. Ya tattva suddhi ke ek prakriya hai. So this is the one of the tattva suddhi. This is the tattva suddhi. This is the one of the purifications and very important kriyas as well. इसी हेतु सर्वप्रथम पारद और अभद्र भिन्न भिन्न समय नक्षत्र और तिथियों के जड़ी बूटियों के रस में पकाया जाता है. सो दिस मर्कुरी एंड ऑल्सो एंड दिस द पारद. पारद मीन्स ऑल्सो मर्कुरी. यू कैन गिव एनी पारद एनी काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. सो व्हाट दे स्पीक अबाउट टू लेट्स सी पारद. सो because this book what I'm reading, I'm just so parad means hame river. So
can you say that the kaya siddhi has its foundation on ayurveda
also? Kaya siddhi also in the ayurvedic science as well, but here I am speaking in the according tantric science. They say parad means the quicksilver. So they use quicksilver, similar words like mercury, mercurial and dependence. So it is a mercury actually. So what I mean here, so parad is the mercury, avagri the mika, special minds. So these are helping to revitalize the body and respiratory systems, lungs, for our sexual organs, reproductive systems. So these are all are fixing and making active everything. So here, so parada means is kind of silver, and that you can take also as a word of mercury. Already I said it. So as you see that Atmanandi asking me about the Ayurveda science. In Ayurveda science we can have the kaya siddhi as well. We say kaya kalpa. This is a kaya kalpa kriyas as well. So there is kaya kalpa. Your body can change this actually many things. Like the Adiguru Shankaracharya, through tantric science, he have the kaya siddhi. That called transmigration vidyas. So he can change actual body to another body as well. That called transmigration. Without kaya siddhi, you can't change the body. Like Lord Hanuman. Lord Hanuman. So Lord Hanuman, and he have this kind of kaya siddhi. He can changing the forms as well, transmigrate. He can have big, he can small and all. It means such a, like Hanuman, Lord Hanuman, he have all kind of perfection of his physical body, the Anamaya Kosha. He is beyond Anamaya Kosha. Am I clear that? Then they say that यह तत्व सुधि की एक प्रक्रिया है. इसे तो सर्वप्रथम पारद और अभय को भिन्न भिन्न समय नक्षत्र और तिथियों में जड़ी बूटियों के रस में पकाया जाता है. सो व्हाट दे डू द सिल्वर्स और द मिका द अवरक दे पुट इन द डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ जड़ी बूटी. जड़ी बूटी मीन्स हियर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ द आयुर्वेदिक रूट्स आयुर्वेदिक मेडिसिन. सो लाइक दैट. And they preparing this, and they also prepare according to the tithis, like sun, like moon, amavasya or purnima, or that is specific, I don't know. So one has to learn this from the gurus only. They have this kind of science. Sabhi prakar visakta tattvon ke unse dur kiya jata hai. So and it is a kind of, as I already said you, the Tantra Vidya, like Vedic science, is all an art of living. It is an art of living, art of lifestyles. So that going to help you and for how to getting out all kind of poisons from our Annamaya Kosha. Isi etu sarapranam parado aur abhar ke bhinna bhinna samaya nakshatra means according to stars, tithyo according to the day, and they have to mix with the all kind of Ayurvedic medicines so that it help you to getting out of kind of a poisons from our own body. That means detoxified, right? In Sanskrit, in the Ayurvedic terminology. जब ये पूर्णतः सुधा भस्म का रूप ले जाते हैं तब तत्व सिद्धि का सारे का शुद्धि के लिए उनका प्रयोग किया जाता है. सो दे यूज एक्चुअली काइंड ऑफ भस्म द एसेस एंड देन एंड यू कैन ईट विथ अकॉर्डिंग टू गाइडेंस ऑफ द गुरुज हु प्रिपेयर्ड. सो आल्सो भस्म इज अवेलेबल ऑलरेडी आई सॉ इन द कंप्यूटर यू कैन सी मिका अभ्रक भस्म इज अवेलेबल इन कोटकल in southern India, Vedic. Very nice medicines in India, the one of the best Ayurvedic medicine available. I don't know in the world, of course, India is the best. So it is the best in the Kerala, the Kottakkal, Ayurvedic Vaidyasala. That's one of the best place, all kind of Ayurvedic medicines. And you can find most oldest also institutions in Kerala. Now is many there, but they have the very authentic. I always use for myself or anything need for my ashrama.
Is this a city or what is this?
Kottakkal, yes, that is the place, that's the city in Kerala as well. Small town, small city also.
In Kerala.
And this kind of medicine they prepare. All kind of medicines are available. And you can check in the Google, Kottakkal, Ayurveda, Vaidyasala. Kottakkal. Kottakkal, Kottakkal, KL. I think Yogananda already know because in ashram we used to buy the Kottakkal by the seller, right? You remember, I think. Then, jab wo purnatah sudha bhasma ki roop lete hain, tab tatsu sudhi ya sare ka sudhi ke liye unka prayog kiya jata hai. So, it is good for the purification of our physical body, the gross body. Uparatapakya ki jankari ki kebala tantriko pi huti. So this kind of knowledge only known by the gurus of the tantra vidyas. And so such kind of science only known by the tantri masters or tantri gurus. It's not available to common people, even common doctors. I don't know even Ayurveda doctors, they know. Impossible, they must know. Because in ancient time, Tantra Vidya also, they always related to also science of Ayurveda as well. So as I see that the all kind of spiritual science coming from Tantra Vidya as well. Uparokta prakya ki jankari ke keval tantriyo ko ki hoti hai. Sadhaka swayam ki niyam anusar parada bhasma tayar karna chahiye. So sadhaka, ye tantrika hai sadhaka, with under guidance of the gurus, they have to prepare their bhasmas. Bana bana kisi se nahi lena chahiye. So such kind of bhasma, like you may read today in the website, you can find in Ayurvedic shops. It's no, you're supposed to not get from the any medical shops or Ayurvedic pharmacy and as well. So they say no, you must prepare yourself. Asudha bhasma ko grahan karne se tatkal mrutyu bhi ho sakti hai. If anyone takes such kind of bhasma outside, likely possible you will die. So there is a dangerous path as well. And anyway, so lot of tantra vidyas, even lot of mantras, even you practice, is actually it can make some kind of bad effect, negative effect to ourselves as well. If the purpose of that mantra need to use for benefit for the humanity. Benefit for the self-enlightenment, not for the material gain. Jo sadhak kayasudhi karta hai, par rog, jara, amriti se prabhavit nahi. So anyone get the perfections of the kayasudhi, that means complete purification of the physical body or over mastery of the anamaya kosha. Then a person free from all kind of sickness and all kind of old age and all kind of death can avoid. Tantra Shastra mein 84 सिद्धों का वर्णन किया जाता है जिन्होंने कायस्थ और अमरत्व की प्राप्ति की. सो देयर इज 84 सिद्धस इन तंत्र दैट द बिग बिग मास्टर्स 84 गुरुस 84 सिद्धस 84 तांत्रिक मास्टर्स हु हैव बीन एक्सपीरियंस कायस्थ एंड दे एंटर इनटू किंगडम ऑफ इमोर्टैलिटी. यह परंपरा शंकराचार्य के परम गुरु गौड़ पादचार्य की पाद लुप्त हो गई हैं. सो दिस काइंड ऑफ तांत्रिक विद्यास वाज एक्चुअली बिकम एक्सटिंक्ट एंड आदिगुरु शंकराचार्य परम गुरु. सो हिज गुरु एंड परम गुरु मीन्स द फोर्थ स्टेजेस गुरु. सो गौड़ पादचार्य लुप्त हो गई. सो दिस इज दैट as per the instructions of the as per the current informations this kind of kayasthi vidyas almost today is extinct, but of course in India such kind of kayasthi is actually not complete finished. I don't think so. So there is extinct extent, but there is, but very selective, maybe one or two gurus maybe know in current age, maybe one or two. So like this, because the knowledge of any kind of spiritual knowledge, as I believe, as I trust, so not actually completely finished. That is always the knowledge. Even either the secrets of the Kriya Yoga, secrets of the Tantra, secrets of Vedanta, secrets of Atmanyana, secrets of Brahmi, is remain there. But maybe we don't have that proper skills. We don't have proper skills. Or proper qualifications. So that we can reach the Gurus. To accept their knowledge and wisdom. अनेक ग्रंथों में वैसे साधों का उल्लेख मिलता है. अनेक ग्रंथों में वैसे साधों को उल्लेख मिलता है. So there is a lot of information you can find with many sources. जिन्होंने कायस्थ की क्रिया द्वारा रोग जरा मृत्यु पर विजय प्राप्त की. So you can find a lot of information with the different sastras. And many sadhakas also, they are free from all kind of sickness and also old age and free from the death as well. Kimbadatya may be as anek logon ka charchati. There is also you can get the reference as well. You understand the reference means you can get a lot of information. As per the sastra in the old age. Jine is abhyas mein saphalata mili hai. So they actually succeed. Such kind of kayasiddhi as well. लेकिन यह जानना कठिन है कि दृष्टांत तत्पर है या कपिलो कल्पित है. So say that it is actually the fact because academic शास्त्र is academic scripture. Is it a fact or it is a imaginations? So there is a little bit of doubts. But I don't have personal doubts. I'm sure that there are yogis, the masters and gurus. They have the science of secret, secret science of Kaya Siddhi, secret science of how to get purification of the physical body. As I say that, like Lord Hanuman, he was Amar, he was immortal, and he never was suffering. So why not? So Lord Hanuman must be great Siddha. You must know that he is the great Siddha out of 84. Doesn't matter what kind of he did sadhana, tantra, mantra, yantra, the many kind of tantra sadhana. As well, also Hanuman does as well. In India, somebody, if you play the black magic, so you pray to Lord Hanuman and he can free from the black magics. No black tantra can make you damage. In India, we have a lot of black tantras. Black tantras. So then after that, say that, लेकिन यह जानना कठिन है कि दृष्टांत तत्पर है या कल्पित कपोल कल्पित. इसी प्रकार के उपलब्धि का कोई वास्तविक प्रमाण इस युग में अभी तक नहीं मिला. सो दिस इन द करेंट टाइम देयर इज नो प्रॉपर काइंड ऑफ एविडेंट हु एक्चुअली हैव द कायसिस. देयर इज नो प्रॉपर एविडेंट, देयर इज नो प्रॉपर प्रूफ. कायसुदी के पीछे रहस्य या उद्देश्य यह है कि शारीरिक तत्वों को शुद्धिकरण के पश्चात साधक को यह क्षमता प्राप्त हो जाए कि वह अपने भौतिक तत्वों का अव्यक्त तत्वों के साथ स्वेच्छा से मिला सके और स्वेच्छा से अलग कर सके. कायशुद्धि की प्रक्रिया से पंच तत्वों पर नियंत्रण विजय प्राप्ति समय संभव है. सो दे सी दैट आकर कायशुद्धि के पीछे सो दैट इज बिहाइंड behind the kayasudhi, behind the mystic of the kayasudhi, so what are the mystic behind it of the kayasudhi? So what are the mystics, what are the mystic is, so how can you keep your physical body, the annamaya kosha, so perfect so that and you are not going to face any kind of sufferings, any kind of difficulties, so that you can do perfect your sadhana, perfect your meditations and perfect your attainment of the samadhi. Kayasuddhi ke prakriya ki se pancha tattvon ko par niyantrana ya bija prapti sambhav hai. They say once you get the perfection of the kayasuddhi, so naturally you are enter into over mastery of the pancha tattva. Understand pancha tattva. Do you understand only pancha tattva, the five tattvas, right, the five elements, like how to over mastery of your physical body? That means you are over mastery of the earth elements, water elements, air elements and fire elements and ether elements, the pancha tattva, right, atmanan. So then naturally you are over mastery of the physical body. This body is composed by five elements, so you can change anything. So therefore the great tantric masters, they always can create the tantric masters, they can always create any kind of miracles, because miracles happens within the five elements if you study properly. So all kind of miracles happens within the five elements. Like for example, somebody flying, what is that? Is it related to air element and ether elements as well? Somebody walking on the water, what is that? A person get the perfection of water element. Somebody walking on the fire, you see that in many stories we saw, we heard even today in modern civilization today, even I was walking on the fire as well. Yeah, our tribals, we do special kind of rituals. But their rituals I can understand is the tantric rituals. But they don't call tantric rituals, it's called Devi. It is called Parasakti. So we believe the Shaktis. And we believe Shakti and we walk on the fire. So many, it is sometimes 100 meters, 200 meters we walk. And in the middle sometimes there water and jaggery and banana, like something. 20 meters after that you put the feet, again walk on the fire. Then after that 20, so like this. Even I have been walking on the fire in age of, that time I was age of, I think 16, something like that. Very young age, teenage. I may be 15, because that time I studied plus two. So in my plus two, I was 15 almost that time. So what I mean that 15, 16. So that time I was walking by spirit. The spirit called me, then I walking on the fire. So these are also tantric practices as well. So kayasiddhi, I mean, you see that if you want to properly meditate, so what you do? So very beginning you practice sort of kriyas, how to cleaning the body, then you study asanas, then you study pranayama, then you study mudras, bandhas, then you study antarmauna, pratyahar, yoga nidra, relaxation, then really going to have concentration of the mind. Then you study discipline of the ashrams. So many things. There's many ashrams in the world, many yoga centers in the world. But you have to find the pure, perfect, and authentic. Not all kind of many people looking, oh, okay, I have money, so I can do little karma yoga, little seva. So I need all physical comforts. Then I do sadhana. So actually, that is not sadhana. Sadhana, when you do under guidance of the guru, and most of the time, we choose guru who can give the all good facilities so that we can do our sadhanas, right? We're searching like this. We're searching in many master places. We don't look the master, but we're searching how the all kind of benefits are available to us materially. So that is nowadays the many sadhakas are like this. And they always want to find the proper facilities. But this is not that if you're looking for material comforts, so never you can proceed for this sadhanas. It's not possible. Sadhana, you have to always work hard. You have to isolate yourself. And isolation means you are free from all kind of sensual enjoyments, sensual pleasures as well. So this person from your all kind of sense does mean you're supposed not eat, not sleep, not mat. You need minimum material needs in order to survive. Not so much need material comforts. That's what I mean. Like Lord Buddha, he was sitting on a tree. He have enough material comforts to meditate. Even he was in the palace, it does not help him to meditate for the enlightenment. So therefore, it's very important and we should take the minimum material needs for our sadhanas. And so otherwise, our mind became very tamasic. Once you depend on all kind of material comforts, your mind became tamasic. So there will be no sadhana. You may happy for a time being, it's fine, but does not continue for a long time. That you must know also. Because you are living in Europe, you have so many material comforts. But same time, you see how much stress and strain you have. And how many people are also and addiction of many kind of drugs, alcohol, and this and that. You look the lifestyles, how it is. And many people, end of the day, they end up with the old age house. So you see, that is the lifestyles of Europe today. You may have money, but there's no proper the family values today, right? So what I mean, I don't mean we suppose not get the material comforts. Yes, we should, but we need a minimum need for survive. So that can help for the our proper sadhanas. Am I clear that? I also see my life when I build the ashram. And when I was no ashram, nothing, I used to spend my time the side of Mother Ganges. Sometimes I have no place to sleep. And night I rain, then I have to sit down under the roof and like this, you know, holding my hands like this and sitting. And whole night. So what I mean here, and that time, so I can pray to God more and more and more and more. And when ashram comes, the mind sometimes turning to some kind of comfortable. So what does that mean? So then again, I started the Panchagni. So Panchagni is give me a lot of inner strength. It's also Kayasudhi as well. Panchagni sadhana is the best way to have purification of the Kayasudhis. But with purifications of Kayasudhi, then also you can do Panchagni vice versa. And when you practice also Kriya Yoga, also is helping your Kayasudhi as well. The techniques are leads all the time. Paramatmana is helping for pratyahar, is helping for concentration. Then naturally we are attending samadhi. Samadhi, no tech. Through samadhi, all techniques not always help for samadhi. Unless you are purification of the chittas. So kayasiddhi important, and kayasiddhi helping for you, and kayasiddhi going to help you how to purification of the chitta as well. So. Kayasudhi is very important and part of the spiritual practice, either yogi practice, tantric practice, or do any kind of meditations, whatever. So please say, keep continue always how to make the purification of annamaya kosha. Annamaya kosha is very important. Anyway, so there is many kind of science. When I speak about to kayasiddhi of the physical body means, so naturally have purification of the annamaya kosha, purification of pranamaya kosha, purification of manamaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, also anandamaya kosha. The five koshas when you are perfect, so naturally you can have the all kind of perfection of the pancha tattvas as well. So today this much, and what kind of you have the questions? Do you have any questions?
We were talking about kaya siddhi and kaya shuddhi.
Kaya siddhi is brings kaya shuddhi as well. Kaya siddhi means purifications, and kaya siddhi means get perfections. Siddhi, get the perfections, purification and perfections. Because purification leads to the perfections. So, am I clear now?
Yes.
So, let we shall. Any other questions, anyone? Julie?
No questions.
Good. And Ashram Gaya Yoga.
No questions, Swamiji.
So okay, all right.
Okay.
So I'll let you include your email so that you can everybody get the invitation by the emails. So sometimes I'm sending by WhatsApp, but not always. So let get always check your emails always. Everybody got the email?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Nice.
Yeah.
And yes. Already have to add for the email of. So his email is more convenient. You can open the computers and you can listen. So nice also. Om Namasevaya Gurave Satchidananda Murtaye Nisprapanchaya Santaya Niralambaya Tejase Om Gongarubhyo Namaha Om Ganganapataye Namaha Om Aim Sarasatai Namaha Om Kling Kalikai Namaha Om Kling Bhadrakali Namaha Om Dundurgai Namaha Om Kim Namah Shivaya Harihi Loka Samastah Bhavantu Loka Samastah Sukhino Bhavantu Lokaha samasta sukhino bhavantu Om Shantihi 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 Harihi Om. So thanks to all of you today.